But let's see how NRG actually manages it, because they get that CT side. They just have to get the good economy, and then they could potentially run away with this. It's going to be interesting.
Despite everything we just said, also looking at how many rounds were traded in that previous, in the first map, first half of the first map.
Chaos.
Yeah, that'd be the debacle for CT. We'll have a look. It is indeed for CT. Which is weird because they spawn on the site, but really, I just call it stairs. Anyway, Legia is behind the smoke. With HE coming in, we've got B. I do wonder if that's something he's practiced before. He's doing minimal damage though. Does do 9 HP to Rick. Here we go. Speaking of Rick, is he going to get 2? Could he even get 3? No, just the 1. And it's down to a 4v3 now. But his T's are winning the jewels here. So 4v2 now for Echo Fox. Legia and Silent are in a bit of trouble. They've got a 2-man aggression towards Roka, which will pay off, but the time is ticking. There is a kit onto Legia, but at this point, surely they can't do this. The other team members can just wait while Sean gets pops faces.
That was so weird because there was so much action, but then I look at like from the CTs and I look at how many players actually died, and I'm like, what? Only 2 died? I feel like they took so many engagements and like we're charging everyone down, but they only got 2 kills. But those are like the hardest 2 kills to get ever. That did not work out very well for NRG. Echo Fox taking that push straight to the bank, and in more ways than one. And that's going to be now the anti-eco for them. I mean, I like that NRG are going full save. They've only got a 5-7 and a deagle and stock pistols. So,
Dink,
the double ring. Yeah, nicely done here from NRG. We saw them do this on the last map on their CT side. It was Silent as well. Silent seems quite proficient, especially with the pistols. So far, and there you go. 2 kills with such a save as NRG just committed to. 2 kills is absolutely fine. They do pressure the economy slightly, and again in this round they could get as they have done a few P250s. 1 flash on God B, I like that as well. Small investment, but a flash in the right place gets you a frag. So, and a kill on God B as well. So, a bit optimistic there, James. A bit optimistic, maybe,
Yes, Dan, this is what I like. Eco round kit, it's the truth. And it's interesting because this is a weird map to... It takes a bit of understanding to know exactly where you have to go to escape the bomb. In terms of the nuke-esque levels of the bomb sites, for example. I do wonder what the plan is with these Molotovs. If it looks like it's generally serving as some kind of fake, perhaps? Or I don't know. I don't know what Sean's plan is here, Dan. But he's dead, Dan.
Oh, wow.
But he's found information, which means it doesn't really matter.
Yeah.
As long as his team is going to seize on this opportunity. Problem is, Shazam's alone now with an AK, and he cannot let this get into the hands of the other side. And it doesn't really matter so much now, but it does matter. Obviously, because there were 2 people left at the time, and he killed 3 people with that AK, so at least there was that.
It's nice with Sean Gesso, because his push there was by design. He was supposed to be alone. He was supposed to get the info, and he had a MAC-10. That he makes him expendable. You can trade him for that information, and that information has won them the round, because there's no way, obviously, Peter gets the kill, but rather the defuse, but... He has survived.
That position is a knife position. You knife people in that position. It is almost impossible for them to go up the ladder with any reasonable pace and look at you standing there, so you knife them. In fairness, if I had an AK, I'd be happy to just take the AK and not risk getting a knife out. But any other weapon apart from an AK on AWP, my knife's out there.
Yeah,
well, my knife's out anyway, Dan.
Yeah, I know. You love knifing people.
I do.
And it goes wrong more than it goes well, James.
Well,
sometimes you do it.
That's
in guaranteed situations. Oh, no, we lost the round now because James found the knife guy and died. Now we have to go to overtime. Thanks, James.
Yeah, that might be true.
So, that's happened.
AWP onto both sides. I'm glad Yanko's just in the back now.
Oh, yeah, he was playing that game as well. Yeah.
He didn't talk after that for a while.
He was tilted. Right, so Peter's playing aggressive with the AWP. This is where you can get energy could gain a lot of edges, because Peter is a good aggressive AWPer, and he's good in a kind of quick firing spot and in a position where he's going to make some fast decisions. But he won't get anything early, so he'll just back away and keep things all calm, serene and tranquil. Hopefully there are some water features. There is a water feature on this map, but it's quite deep. The water fountain there.
I forgot about you and your water features, Dan.
Water features are calming, they're very nice. I do like water features, like fountains. Anyway, running water, relaxing, but Peter.
Tell us more.
Ooh, that was a stunning shot there on Ichiban.
Forget the match. Tell us more.
Ichiban to the bench. As Peter picks up the frag and will Roka go for something here? Obviously, if Roka gets some kills, if he goes just full out Nico mode, obviously that's going to be really nice for Echo Fox. Because right now Echo Fox don't have many options. They're trying to push toilets, but we'll see the slight pushing there towards toilets. Lavatories, and there it is. Silent takes down Roka. So now Echo Fox probably feel quite committed towards the A side. They've got to go for it. Shazam is going to create an opportunity, but will they drive the push all the way to the bank?
To the bank. Well, time will tell. NRG still has the man advantage for the moment. Peter peeks out, gets taken down by Rix. How much information does he have for his team? There is a CC towards Optimus. Justin's coming in to support as well. Spraydown comes in. Everybody's blind. Justin through the smoke takes down two. Could have been a third as well. Shazam's down to 13 HP. And he's got 1 second to run away. Run for the hills, Dan. Run for his life.
That's not how it goes,
I don't
James.
Even know the song.
That's not how it goes.
Run for the life, run for the hills?
No.
Run for the life? What? What is it then?
Run to the hills, run for your life. Run to the hills.
Who sings it? Guns N' Roses?
You're just trolling, you are. You know it's like me. It's actually, if you read the lyrics of that song, it's actually not too pleasant of a subject matter, James. Maybe one day you'll find out. You're reading the lyrics of the song. There you go, past the water fountain. Shazam will go with his AWP. Leggy in a very full position, actually, but quite an off angle. So Leggy is committed to see. Oh, God. Leggy is in a lot of trouble. He's not able to get some damage in towards connector. Because if. Okay, Ichiban actually won't push. Because they could have sandwiched connector to try and take control of it in case a CT was lurking there. Obviously, if you see a player pushed, you kind of want to. You generally want to check that connector is going to be clear. But Ichiban, actually, with this second sense for the CTs and their movement, is going to be able to pick up the frag and the gun. And now NRG are in a lot of trouble, but maybe, just maybe, Justin can go Zipex mode. We saw Zipex in this kind of position. Actually, he did like a 1v4 just by himself towards the A site the other day versus, who was it? Some good team. I forget who. But here we go. In they are, towards the A site from long. It's all down to Justin here to get the damage. Oh, he gets flashed. What a flash there from Echo Fox. That is brilliant play. Spray from God B, but he can't get more than one. And Echo Fox win another round, so this is looking like a terrible start for NRG, James. They are getting wrecked right now. Their money must be atrocious. Atrocious.
Well, Simon's got 3k in the bank.
Let's have a look at the money. Let us see the money. Let's do the economic forecast.
Oh, well.
Oh, yo, nice trolling there. Someone's getting fired, Jeff.
Nobody else has any money, Dan. So, Silence money was misleading, Dan.
Yeah.
Like one of those Nigerian emails.
Do you know why?
We were led up the garden path.
It's because the AK was saved that one round. I think that was the reason.
You might be right. I thought that was Peter.
Yeah, but maybe he probably dropped it to buy an AWP.
You might also be right. You might be right twice over. Well, yeah, the money sucks.
Yeah, oh, I like this so much. Drop the AWP, give it to Peter. You can play the AWP without armor pretty well. Are they actually going to go for force here? Full force. I thought maybe just, you know, he would spend. Oh, well, I guess it makes sense. They're all completely broke. They just got reset. So this makes a lot of sense. I would love to see NRG do something creative with this round. It's going to be very difficult, though. Echo Fox are probably going to be on alert. They're going to think, all right, these guys, their money, it has to be screwed right now. They've got to be on a force buy. I mean, they should be able to read the money very well. It's much easier these days because all you have to do is press tab. You can see who died, how many players died in every round. The players can see that as well. So, yeah, the players can see all this. So it's quite easy to calculate the money for both sides most of the time. But not all the time.
Three towards B for NRG. And Echo Fox will use the time, speaking of time, that they have afforded to them. You can see the setup of NRGs. They've abandoned the mid area, if you will, or the short A area, whatever you like to call it. Violent gets traded, but he's got teammates in support. The 5-7 says no. The Rick's man advantage disappears with Shazam taking down Legia towards the birthday party area, worst birthday party of the year. Bomb gets collected. And it moves towards the teammates who are creeping up towards the A side. Oh, Storm Drills is going to get taken down by Peter. More trades coming in, 2v2.
Yeah, they've actually made a chance for themselves in this force buy. Pretty awesome force buy if you can open some rifles. Oh, here we go. Ichiban catches Justin opening the door. But so another door-to-door salesman out there. It is a very angry Ichiban with an AK-47. And that bomb will go down. And what can Gobby do to save this? Will he switch for the AK? Yes, he will. A bit more dynamic with the rifle. Here he goes. Gobby's got a really, really tough task in his hands. Doesn't know where these two players are. Oh my god, Shazam had no idea Gobby was coming.
Wham, bam, Shazam.
Now it's down to a 1v1. Ichiban, is he going to go all the way around? Looks like he will. And Gobby, it's very hard for him to know. He's just got to react very quickly here. Just, there's the tap. Is he going to hold? There is surely no way to hold this. Okay, I guess there is. So he would die for doing
Why is
so.
He getting his pistol out?
I don't know. Well, it looked like he wanted just to hold it as well. It looked like he wanted to just sit on it. Because otherwise, you would just tap it, right? And just crouch there.
I mean, I think he had to hold it because he had a no defuse kit. And if he fakes, he probably is not going to have time if he manages. I think what I think his read is the initial peak is unlikely unless they think they're smart enough to think, okay, the CTM economy is shot, so they probably don't have a kit. If he's smart enough, then more power to him. But in a vacuum, I think most of the time he thinks the first peak is the first tap is a fake. I think that's Gobby's read, that the T will think the first tap is a fake, so he goes for, well, that was interesting. Let me just stand right in front of you while you fire an AK-47. Oh no, I've taken some damage.
Yeah, that's a little bit weird, isn't it? Maybe he's trying to get his attention. Double peek. It's good actually, they pick up the headshot there. Gobby survives on 1 HP. I don't know how long he will stay standing, but for now, he lives. But soon he will be delivered to Valhalla. Okay, here we go. Smoke over the top there from Sean Gares. Now the bomb is moving up towards the A side of the map, so Sean Gares is just making it very confusing here. And he himself will probably be a little bit confused. How the hell did Peter get into that position with none of my teammates being able to spot that at any point? But he will deal with it. And it will be Echo Fox slowly moving towards the A side of the map once again. Things are very slow, James, at the moment.
Yes, they are.
Very slow indeed.
I like that smoke that Sean threw. I don't know if it's a worthwhile smoke to throw every round, for example. Which is, you know, there are certain smokes I like to see thrown every round. Just like Astana Dragons used to make the wall of smoke on Nuke outside every single round on the T side. Because, again, like some CTs throw a similar smoke from CT spawn that lands on the CT side of Monster Tunnel, which I think is a weakness for the CTs. And that smoke is like a deeper one, essentially. But if you throw that a lot, then that's going to be a huge problem for the in knowing how much to bolster the bomb site. The CT's not really getting much out of this at the moment. It's eco rounds. So this is a disastrous, I repeat, this is a disastrous start for NRG.
This sucks.
I'm expecting 3 maps already. But you never know, especially with North American teams.
It's early days, because Echo Fox might just run over, you know, NRG, when they get to their T side, they might just be the same as us too. They might just run over CT side of NRG, of Echo Fox. English is hard, James. Just generally thinking is difficulty. Cognitive function, I find quite challenging.
We have seen that a few times on the likes of Inferno, actually, where you've seen strong T halves and terrible CT halves by both teams. Well, there's a super fast blank coming in here. Ooh, they've heard something, and Peter's going to get wrecked. So NRG on the pistols and Kevlar here, and they are not going to get anything out of it whatsoever. Rix, that is greedy. There is a time and a place to pick up a pistol. And now you're dead, son. And now you're dead.
Now he's alive.
Now he's alive, but now he has $700, Dan, instead of $5,600. That is the price you pay. For greed, for gluttony. Think about that. He spent $4,900 instead of $700 to buy the Deagle later on. Dangerous, dangerous.
Wow. Probably expect another slow round. You can see the Echo Fox, they really like to be safe. They like to play carefully, James. They like to check every single nook and cranny. All the crannies and all the nooks are to be checked thoroughly.
thorough inspections done. Making sure they meet sanitary standards.
Yep.
I wonder if their toilets have a clipboard in them. You know, you see like every hour and a half, someone has to check the toilets.
A rota, basically.
There should be a clipboard in there. If there isn't a clipboard, I might actually email Valve and say, I have an issue. Valve, I know you don't respond all the time, but this needs a response. I don't see a clipboard in the toilets. Or a guy there with perfumes.
Yeah,
one of the two needs to happen.
The dude with perfumes, let's go.
Yeah.
Or, is it really perfumes?
Fragrances,
I should say fragrances.
Shall I say fragrances?
Or colognes, maybe.
Yeah, well, Echo Fox have decided on the B bomb player. Nice counter flash from Silent, and he won't get sprayed. Oh, he's got the bomb down first as well. Teammates in for support. He's got Justin here. More spray downs coming in, but two straight back for the T's.
Yeah, crazy take coming in. Oh, Peter. Oh, come on. Almost getting that second shot as well. This guy is in such a good position here. That first shot, though, that really, really enabled NRG to have a strong presence back into this bomb site, and the T's cannot do anything. Dying after time. Roka is going to have absolutely no loss bonus, but luckily his team has a lot of money anyway, so it won't matter too much. But NRG, you know, they're going to win a round, and they're going to win a round at the last point in which it could allow them a reasonable comeback. So they can, if they can get to, you know, 5-6, they can legitimately get to 5-8 rounds now, whereas before it was looking like getting even 3 or 4 rounds was incredibly difficult. But now they've done it. They've secured themselves some weapons due to the nature of that round win. And now Echo Fox's money is going to start to be a little bit strained. So NRG might be able to capitalize on some ecos. But what they do have to deal with is these incredibly passive starts from Echo Fox, which must be frustrating for the CTs because they're not getting any info. And Roka's just going to straight up raw peek Justin and just pump him for the bullets, James. And he is now very dead. Very dead indeed. Down to Peter here on the defense of the toilets. He's going to get smoked off. Smoke one way, fire the other. Now he's probably going to realize I'm a bit too close here. He's going to be committed here if the T is going to wrap him. But actually, they decide to go towards long. So Peter still has some ability to get out of there. Oh, great peek into the flick shot. Peter, nice little adjustment there on the crosshair. And now they probably have a good idea of what's going on. Very, very devious angle found as well with the boost. But will this boost end up being a problem, James, or will it end up saving them?
Peter is a problem at the moment. Peter, the problem.
I like the name as well.
Oh, he sees the legs.
Daddy Pete. Nice.
Nice indeed. And Sean Gares gets taken down. And Rick's was legs in the toilets by Peter earlier on. Down 17. So this is a strong position for NRG at present. Two per site. Although there's a bit of a push coming in from Legia, which could turn into a flank towards the B bomb site, but surely he would get there with all the action. Silent going to do a bit of counter peeking there. See what's going on. Oh, that is absolutely disgusting. Three-man spray down by Silent. He's been playing very strong recently, and he needs to continue that because they are still four rounds behind that.
All the mans sprayed down.
The mandem got cold steel, hot lead, everything.
The cold steel and the hot lead.
All the temperatures, Dan. All the temperatures. The fridge and the freezer and the heater. Let's go.
The heater, is that how you cook things? I cook with the heater.
Blowtorch, Dan. Let's go.
The blowtorch.
When I was in Tokyo, I had fresh sushi blowtorched.
Yeah. Yeah, I had, actually, when I was in Taipei this summer, we had octopus blowtorched. It was pretty good.
Well,
it's on my Instagram.
Ichiban got the blowtorch to the jaw. Go to your PCR.
Oh, God, James, it's happening.
Shazam to train.
It's happening, isn't it?
3-3, two rifles now on the Echo Fox side. They are on the eco, Dan. Shazam has no armor, but he's picking up a victory gun. Godbeast's gonna get sprayed down by Rick. It's all falling apart here. We've stolen weapons, Dan, and stolen territory.
Yeah, hot property here in the hands of Echo Fox. Say it ain't so, James. Say it ain't so.
What is this?
Losing to the eco again.
Again?
Again, it's happening. It's too much. But then again, they were playing very, very forward positions against Eco. Actually, we all see most teams do in rounds like that. They'll actually play much, much further back, just generally so that you can't get wrapped and caught in these and isolated so easily. If you play on the site, you can, unless the T's invest a lot of grenades, you should always be able to get a good range, at least mid-ranges, where your rifles will be much better, as well as the opportunity to have some time to place trades or use nades yourself. So we'll see them be punished for that. That forward setup, and now it's going to be down to the eco of their own. It's like it's going to work out so far, James. Two frags for the price of one. I call that a bargain.
Yeah, but the bargain placement continue here. Nice question. Down to three versus three. The T is in control of the site, but how do they plant the bomb in situation? Shazam now down to 12 HP. Sean Gears is going to change things considerably. One versus three now. Silent is in the smoke. Sean trying to spray, but how does he manage to breach here without getting taken down? Sean is hungry on this position, and Sean will indeed punish him for trying to do what he can for his team, Dan, for his country, for his people.
Civil war right now, civil war. Real bloody war, James. 3-9, not a good CT sided score. On Overpass.
No, it's not.
Not gonna lie.
No, it is not. It sucks, Dan. I'll see you on the third map. I will see you, Dan, on the third map. Although,
well,
I mean,
calling it already, James. What is that?
You never know, Dan. You never know. I'm not so much calling it as I'm challenging NRG to do better than they're doing at the moment. I want to see more, Dan. As they say in boring English politics, we must do more.
We must do more. That is the best statement ever. We must do more. That's amazing.
And it always said,
we must do more.
More must be done. We must do more. Blah 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 blah. Let me appease you with more must be done. I'm angry. And more must be done.
More must be done. That's such the most ridiculous thing
I've
ever
heard. It's just nonsense, isn't it, Dan?
Yeah,
it's so, the B word that so you're going to deploy. Yes, it is. Well, got B in a position where he can rotate should he want to. Other than that, other than God B, ignoring God B for a moment, we have two per site, as per usual here, for the NRG side, which are lacking in success here on the second map of this best of three, taking the first one, Dust 2. And Echo Fox are standing around, Dan. They are train spotting.
Roka's in the dirty water, man.
Roka is literally train spotting right now, Dan. He's got his bifocal glasses on and his waterproof notepad, Dan, and his Mac. And he's using a pencil in case the pen fails. He's train spotting, Dan.
He looks like he's a bit disinterested in the trains. Now, there's no more trains to be spotted. He will exit the dirty water and he'll make his way in for an entry. He's quite low on health, actually. Down to 26 points of health. Four now, after he takes 20 damage there, but the trade comes in. And look at this, James. These camera angles. They're not something to be marveled. Are you marveled? Marveling? Are you marveling?
There is an argument for third person with all the smokes going on. Otherwise, you have no idea what's happening.
Yeah, I think it can create a good picture of areas. Because I think that's the thing that you miss with first-person mode, is that it's harder to have a sense for what is going on. Like, visualizing map control is it, like when you see a team take an area, like seeing the third person, you get a much better sense, okay, this area is now under this team's control. I think that's really cool. But anyway, it's beside the points. We're at 4-9 right now here. NRG definitely trailing much more than they would like to be, especially on Overpass. It makes their chances in this map quite difficult as they switch sides. But if they can get to 5 or 6, they definitely have a good shot. They're able to win the pistol round in the second half. But again, Echo Fox taking it very slow, frustratingly slow perhaps for NRG. In fact, this slow pace could very well be forcing some errors from NRG as they just sit there with itchy trigger fingers, wanting the action desperately. And it will come. It will come, perhaps, inside the reticle of Peter. Here is the challenge. Will they try to boost up here? Oh, Peter is so ready for this.
Oh, like dope.
So ready.
Surprise. Coming around the industrial container with a tidy moustache.
He wants more James.
Saying surprise. I respect the push through the smoke. I respect it. What are the T's going to do? We've got Ishiban and Roka with possession of short B, which is always a strong place to control. You can see the problems it causes, the CTs, and the places where it's not safe for them to peek monster, for example.
You can actually see to the right of the pillar, you can see the edge of barrels from where Ichiban is. Now Molotov that can be employed to cause more problems. So just as the CT starts to rotate out of the B bomb site, the push comes in. Justin though is alive and he can get himself 2-1v1. The bomb carry gets taken down. Running into the site with the bomb in his hand is never a good idea. Man advantage now for the CTs. CTs get the bomb down just in time. And now they all get wiped out there, the Echo Fox side. I don't know why you would run onto a bomb site from short with the bomb in your hands before you're even on the site. Just why would you do that? You can just press 5 when you're on the site, Dan, and then you have the bomb.
He believed too much.
It's like he
believed too hard.
He couldn't even see if the smoke was good from the place where he started running with the bomb in his hands. He is the same player who got roasted by Sean Gez, Dan. And he was like, I don't have a nade. And someone's like, well, buy one then! Buy a grenade!
I caught it!
You don't have a nade? Buy a grenade! Is that the level of instruction required?
Yeah.
Perhaps you should buy a grenade. Well, they're trying to come in, are the keys, to the B bomb site in the last round of the first half. And the counter flash to the real Dan. The bomb's on the floor. People are getting wrecked all over the place. I have no idea what's going on. Everyone's dying. It's a 2v2.
Now here comes Peter. And here comes Legia. Looking to save the CT. No! But Peter will be able to get the trade there. Nice little flick there under pressure. A lot of pressure. But Ichiban, he's stuck on the bomb site. He's going to try to smoke himself. Well, an option right now. And he's going to be jumping over the smoke. And Peter's going to actually predict that. Good, smart play there from Peter. Knows what to expect. He knows all the tricks. It would seem, the tricks of the trade as he moves in now, smoking offshore. But that smoke is so powerful because Peter has no idea exactly where Ichiban could have disappeared to just due to that one smoke. So that smoke is massive. Ichiban will not pick up the kill though. Peter will save the round there for NRG and they will actually get 6 on the board. So that's something to work with. And we have no idea what to expect for the second half. Like this, it could very well be another T-sided half. That's absolutely possible. So honestly, it's I would not judge this matchup by any normal expectation for Overpass.
Yeah,
that's what I would.
They've reduced the score from shameful to mildly embarrassing here, 6-2-9 in favor of the T's. I mean, that was pretty terrible for NRG. Basically, they just got eaten alive for reasons unknown.
It seemed like there was a strong possibility when they took rounds, but they would always get wrecked by, you know, these eco rounds and these situations where they would just get caught off out of position and the setups weren't quite tight enough. And NRG were a team that, you know, in my opinion, they have a lot of potential. You can see it on the maps where they're comfortable, but I think Overpass here does show that their map pool's not that deep yet. And I think that's what, you know, needs to be developed over time, obviously. But yeah, you can definitely see the chinks in the armor there, and Echo Fox were able to exploit. And that slow pace is really frustrating to play against. So I think NRG didn't really know how exactly to handle it. We didn't see much in the way of, you know, taking, like, having setups to pressure the A side of the map with coordination. Like, for example, if you watch a team like Astralis or something, they're a really good Overpass team to watch for just like these little pockets of aggression towards A long or towards the toilets. How you do it right, how you make it safe, and how you get out of there. And what you get from it is how they play the information they get from it too. Because even if you don't see anything, or if you see one guy, like, that should generate response and inform rotation and so on and so forth. So all those little aspects, nuances, which is very important to Overpass. We didn't really see that. NRG looked a little bit like they relied on Peter so much to be able to pick up those frags. And if he couldn't do it, then they were in trouble.
Also worth noting that Echo Fox did win a pistol. And they did break NRG after NRG won all of one round on the first buy round. So that's basically 6-1 straight away. Yeah. If you think about it. So, it went to 7-1. So to come back to 6-9 from 1-7.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Is a good comeback. So once they got on their feet, they did a reasonable job. They got the last 3 rounds as well. But obviously losing the pistol and getting broken after one round is almost worst case scenario.
Yeah, it's again one of these situations where, like, again, if you look at when Astralis are playing teams that are worse than them, I take Astralis as an example just because I've cost a few of their games recently and they are a top team and they're one of the better teams fundamentally at the top level, I would say. But they would always get in spots where when they finally win that buy round, after that, it's just they play it so efficiently and so perfectly. They make sure they minimize all the ways that the opposition could win a round with a disadvantageous situation on pistols or, you know, whatever kind of buy that they have, which is worse than their own, they play it optimally. And we saw from NRG, they gave up those rounds way too easily, and that just put them in a weird spot. But here's the pistol. Here is NRG taking very solid control of connector, the door area. Oh, wow, here we go. We've got the push back in.
It's a popo, Dan.
Echo Fox want to get straight back in there. They're not just happy to lose two players there for free. And they're going to lose more players, James. They're going to compound the problem. The problem is now larger. And Justin's just sitting there, just open to the peaks that you have to...
Give him the 1v1, Dan. It's a mere 4v2. Yeah. Why play the advantage, Dan? Let me open this door and have the inferior range of my Glock against this USP.
Yeah, that's definitely a misplay from Justin, absolutely. Because that's the full sense of security, because it's 4 versus 1. You got to respect Ricks. Ricks is a sick clutch player, and here he goes, looking for the clutch. He'll get shut down, but yeah, you want to make that hard.
Yeah, it was 4v2 at the time. He could control 4v2. The rotation.
Exactly, yeah.
But, I mean, again, like...
He could even have run down and shot the door, for example. That's like another play he could have
done. Say that again, sorry?
He could have run down the stairs, not on the angle, but just shut the door. There's another thing he could have done. There's lots of different ways he could have played that,
yep.
Which weren't facing for the raw aim battle, which would have almost ensured a victory for his team.
Yeah, I know, but I mean, specifically because it's a Glock versus a USP.
As well, that's why you don't ever
Why would you do that?
You shouldn't take that fight.
Why would you do that?
I mean, you can take that fight, but it's not optimal to do that.
Yeah, I mean, I think if you're not within the range, I don't know exactly if he was in the range, because it is really bad of the Glock. I'm just trying to think of what it is. Well, I know what it is. It's like 580, I want to say, units.
Or units, okay.
But in terms of physical space, I think it might be around the borderline of a one-shot of a Glock.
What is the running speed? How many units per second is it again?
Running speed.
I know how much it is in Quake.
With
3.
With but what? With what weapon?
With a pistol.
No idea. Yeah. I don't know the running speed of any guns. <then. laughs> But I thought I'd ask you to specify anyway.
Nice.
Well, with what gun then? You have to be more specific. Well, I have no idea of any gun.
Nice.
But thank
nice.
You for asking.
Oh, dear.
Anyway, the Molotov's out. And it is going to be thrown down. Back to you.
All right, well, that Molotov is burning away. And now it's likely dissipated after 7 seconds. So the push will come in towards the long side, or rather the hold towards the long side. The investment from Echo Fox on their eco is towards the long side, the connector area there, as you can see. Just very innocent looking benches there. Maybe you could sit down, take a rest, but then the police are going to come and slap you in irons.
What happens in New York?
Was sitting on the bench, you get arrested. Get off that bench!
They are pressured to write people up for the sake of it, which is why everyone hates the police in America. Then
the statistics culture.
Because they have good reason, unfortunately.
The statistics culture. Good government. Way to govern. Sorry. Oh,
this is another way to govern, Dan. Mac-10's taking down people. Ooh, well, I thought Shazam was going to get more than one, but unfortunately, it was only to be the one. Roki gets taken down to 16 HP. I was going to say, surely to be eliminated then, but in fact, he's still alive. Possibly the most dangerous man on the team at the moment, Roka. He is trying to hide. That's why he's facing the floor. He's not admiring his shoes. Police shoes often look like absolute... They look boring anyway.
It's not really a fashion statement. It's not really a fashion statement, is it?
No, it's not.
If you look at the police in the UK, right, and the hats, those big hats they wear.
Yeah.
They're not really built for purpose in terms of. I need to chase people down the road.
Maybe you could throw them at people, couldn't you? They can put stuff in there.
I was in Notting Hill Carnival once, and
extra storage, James.
I was in Notting Hill Carnival once, and this kid had stolen a policeman's hat, and he ran past me holding it, and then like 5 seconds later, he saw the policeman running after him, and he was never going to catch up with him. It was hilarious. Anyway, the CT is back on the eco once again. Thorngez gets on the little shelving there, but won't be able to hide behind the paint. That's a nice kill considering the distance there for Ricks onto Legia.
CZ is very unexpectedly accurate at such ranges, I would say, especially when you tap it. But Roka, in with that flank. Roka, here he goes.
Oh, it's too late now.
He's coming in. Oh, God. Oh, no. It's become embarrassing, James. It's become awkward. After the first couple of shots, it's awkward.
The P250 sucks compared to the 5.7 from that range.
Yeah, it's awful. The CZ is very hard as well when their back is to you, because headshots from a player that's back is facing you is kind of feels kind of weird.
Yeah,
it's less consistent, obviously.
On the subject of the CZ, yes. I played against Scream randomly at 4 o'clock in the morning. Oh, matchmaking yesterday. I've played Scream at 4 o'clock in the morning yesterday. Yeah. I lost 3-16 on cash, but I'm blaming my teammates.
Standard.
I got 2 kills with a CZ. I was happy with that because I've only equipped it recently. I never used it that much in the past. I've been convinced. So I'm going to try and stick with it for a while on the TC side specifically.
You have to learn how to like tap with it, how to burst with it, and how to spray with it. Like, yeah, there's like so many different applications to depending on situations. And so you can tap a lot of headshots with it from mid ranges. It's really good sometimes.
Yeah.
Anyway, we do have the full buy in from Echo Flip, so they should be good here. They should be good to have a solid defense. MAC-10 is, or rather, MP7 is on God B. Oh, and the push coming in from Echo Fox. Here it goes, just in close. You'll get eliminated. Nicely done, actually, by Echo Fox to realize that they could get a 2-for-1 of 2-versus-1 there. Not a 2-for-1, but a 2-versus-1.
Enough of your bargains, Dan.
My bargains. My basement bargains. They call me Basement Bargain Dan. There you go. Nice side kill coming in from Michiban, but this is no way to trade there because Shazam is on the site. He's very far away. Unless he fired a missile.
Because he's very far away.
Unless he had a bazooka. A panzer.
Or an air raids. What do they have in COD? Is it air raids or something?
Don't know.
Or they have airstrikes.
I just remember the Panzerfaust from RPCW. Oh, there you go. That's a nice peek. I like that, James. Sometimes Shazam is an artist.
Well, like one of those elephants with a brush.
Exactly.
Well, it's 9-9. NRG trying to get their lead back that they had, which is a figment of their imagination now, a figure of the past. I don't know if he's spotted yet. Well, they know where he is now. Going for the plant. His teammate has got the cross covered. And the bomb will go down. There's a man advantage for the CTs at the moment. And that will be Rick's rotating in. So no flank for the CTs, but the Ts won't know that. How long will they hold these angles for? Down goes one. Spanet still holding the angle. Here, there goes Roker as well. Rick's alone, gonna jump up and get taken down. So Echo Fox had a chance then, but the chance was swiftly taken away by the NRG side. That's gonna put Echo Fox into Eco Fox, basically.
Eco.
Yeah, it's gonna make Echo Fox Eco Fox. So they've taken the H away, Dan.
Taking it away.
Where's your H, bro?
You mean H?
Looks like
you're Echo more than Eco. You're one of those people that says H. That's actually like,
what do you say?
A pet peeve of mine. I say H.
H.
H, yes.
But it's a H.
Yeah, but there's no, but if you look in the dictionary, there is no H there, only an A, I, T.
I shall look into this.
If you would read the dictionaries, you always talk about that, James, you would know this.
I will. I was in prison then, I'd read the dictionary. It would save me from
there's
other
a lot
activities.
Of things we've heard about you and no, a lot of things that you would do in prison, right, lady James?
It would save me from other activities, Dan. Well, I wouldn't need saving necessarily, but, you know. Let's just say I'd read the dictionary.
So you'd work in the library instead of the kitchen or something?
Well, I'd probably be in solitary confinement, Dan.
Would you see yourself as on the mail duty or...?
What's mail duty?
Maybe laundry. Delivering mail
duty. Oh, mail. I thought you meant M-A-L-E. I was like, what? What's that? I don't know. Moving swiftly on, Echo Fox have 2 pistols remaining in this round. And that's about it.
So back to the prison. I've never considered what I would do if I was in prison.
Read the dictionary, Dan.
I don't think I'd do that. I think I would. I think what I would do.
I don't know that you would find the intellectuals you'd be seeking.
I would write a few novels, I think.
Oh, you would?
Yeah. Maybe some novellas. Perhaps?
You would be reading the dictionary, mate.
Absolutely.
You ain't writing no novels.
Why not? I can write words.
Yeah, but what if your roommate, like, runs out of toilet paper?
Well, I would just request some regular paper. I don't know what kind of prison you would get sent to, but I'm not going to get sent to.
I would probably be in solitary confinement.
For doing what?
I don't know.
Dictionaries.
Yeah.
This guy keeps stealing dictionaries. Solitary confinement.
Shanking people for dictionaries. Give me your dictionary.
Give me a dictionary. Just pulling out the sharpened toothbrush.
Yeah.
Give me that dictionary.
I'm here for life. You better give me a dictionary. 2-round lead for the NRG side. Can they keep things up here? That is not a good start. Shazam taking God B down for free. Often with that smoke that the CT's deployed, you can stand on the bench and look over the smoke towards the T ramp. But the T's will be expecting that. That said, it's still hard for them to see through it if they don't have a scope.
I like this here again. Again from Echofox. This is nice. You know, you see them taking map control away. Or, well, if there was a T here, and previously there was, but this time there isn't. So they take map control for free. That wasn't picked up by the T's. So they immediately know now by taking sewers that it is very, very unlikely that there's like three or four guys outside Monster, which is the only place they haven't cleared. And oh, that is fantastic.
Beautiful. Ricks
catches a guy in connector. This should surely tell them exactly what's going on. This should be rotation right now. I don't know why there's so many players on B, to be honest, at this point in the round. They will be swiftly rotating towards A, where all the players are coming. But swiftly, they are being eliminated, neutralized by the AWP of Shazam, as Peter now looks to try and find a trade. We'll have to see whether or not he's going to be able to do so. Or it will, okay, it can be silent as well. In with the frag. Two versus three here as the NRG side try to get onto the A bomb site. They have 30 seconds to plant the bomb. They now have 27 seconds to plant the bomb, James.
How much time do they have now, then?
Now it's 24. Time is constantly going down, James. Consistently at a rate of seconds. And now there is less time than there was previously. 15 seconds now, and things are looking even worse. Peter moving into the bomb site here. Oh, what a kill there. The hip shot there, just a shotgun AWP, trying to get the bomb planted. Oh, he actually pulls it off inside the smoke.
Uh-oh.
Oh, this is dangerous now. Peter can win the round from this point. They know where he is, but he is fast on the snaps. Just flashing himself out to get some angles to hold, and here he holds. Oh, the peek from Roker.
That Roker
could have
too
gone
good.
So badly.
Roker's too good, man. Nice pick up by Echo Fox, a very important player for the team. Yeah. Clutching the round for the sides.
Clutch.
But look at the money on NRG. They can keep the pressure up for another two rounds at the very least.
Yeah, this is actually really good for NRG in some senses because it's kind of like the right round to lose. You get three kills. There are only two survivors for Echo Fox. And you can see the result on their money. Only one player with any money, $3,000 on Sean Gares. I think that's the monster, the outside monster smoke. Yeah, this is...
Oh, that's
go.
The bad one.
You don't like, yeah, that's one you don't like. And I agree as well because
that's the one where you deserve to get. Look at it. You have no warning of anything there. I could stand in that smoke and right click, drop a flashbang, and then charge. You could just charge through that. And I think people eventually will. We've seen Olafmeister do it on his own. There we go. So you listen warning, but there are flashes from far away. Not a two-man spray down. Sean is still blind, and he will be taken down, but the trades are coming all over the place. Roker's run out of bullets. He's going to get taken down as well. Two versus two. The CTs are coming back down. Is it too late, Dan?
I don't know. Peter's down there with an AWP by Monster, so he might be able to do something from that position just with 10 HP, but he should be safe, able to get long-range engagements. Oh, Legius is going for the manly play there in the smoke. This is risky business right now, risky business. The timing is so hard to work out, and he actually gets a frag from it. The trade in from Peter, straight up from short, ran all the way around, and that's the round there for NRG. That's such an important one because look at the money for Echo Fox.
Baby, I Spoilers, got your money.
There ain't none.
Hey, there ain't none. Dirty. Baby, I got your money, don't you worry. Say hey. I can't sing that.
You should practice then.
I don't really care, I suppose. Echo Fox down to the pistols. Is that a smoke onto Sean Grills? Damn, Shazam, wham bam. He's up there with the kills. But it's not enough, Dan. It's not enough. He needs more because Echo Fox have got no money and the two rounds behind. NRG, though, can they take it over the line there? Can they get...
Which line?
The finish line.
Ah,
I thought you had me there.
Yeah, I was like, what's he going to do now? He wasn't expecting anyone to try to trip him up there. But he seems to be able to.
I had to finish. Cope. I had to think about it. What line am I talking about?
what is this? What is this line? Yeah. Everyone talks about this line all the time, James, but no one defines the line.
Indeed.
Now the line has been defined.
I should have said washing line.
The washing line.
Can they take it over the washing line? Because it's the only line they had available. Roker's position, will it be checked? We've got three Molotovs onto the T side. But throwing a nade would give away their position. That said, there are two. God B's going for it. Oh, but Roker's going to get the shot straight in the face there. Trades coming in for both sides, but they're favouring the CTs in this situation. They are on Yiko. Oh, Ishivan's dancing, but this is not the time for DDR, mate. This is not the time for DDR. Going for the shoulder picks, but he's just far too wide. Sean Gares on the site there with CZ. He could do damage here, and he will. Two AKs left for the T side. Now it's just down to Ricks alone. on Optimus. He is going to get the spray down. The full garden hose, Dan.
That's a save, man. That could have gone pretty poorly. Yeah, the DDR. I suck at DDR.
I was always too embarrassed to try to learn it in the arcade, because where else are you going to learn it?
Yeah, you have to spend ages learning it.
I went
to an arcade and you know, you see people practice, basically just practicing all the time. You can't just be good at DDR, you've got to practice that stuff.
Well, if Echo Fox are able to get this abysmal buy over the finish line, then NRG could have a force, but they'd have like no nades. They'd have AKs, but no nades in the next round, but yeah.
There goes the push. Echo Fox trying to take that engagement. They're not going to find it. Oh, what's that through the smoke? Silent, you beast! Fun impressing me today. And oh, this round looks like a complete cleanup at the moment. Ichiban. I hunger for ramen. I need to go back to Canada, yeah, for more ramen.
Legia flying through with a knife.
No.
Unfortunately, Ichiban was out of knife range, Dan, and he got shot with bullets.
Let us see. Wait, first. Okay, we'll see the money anyway. Because it's the end of the round. I was like, let's find a moment to see the money. But here is the money. The money sucks. Record Fox. Looks like NRG are looking good for the 2-0 right now. And again, you know, James, this is the opposite of how we expected it. But the advantages for NRG they're taking against Echo Fox is on the T side. It's their T sides. Well, both teams were not able to have good CT sides, actually. It actually applied for both teams. But it's NRG with their drills and perhaps their confidence as a team. And their practice, their structure that they have, that's giving them the edge on their T-sides. And now Echo Fox full save, going aggressive towards toilets, towards the water feature. And the door. It's two men's in the door. Two men's. All the men's, but only two of them. Here goes Shazam. He must have spot. I think he's got the spot in there. Oh, look at that. The slump. He's dead. He's dead, James.
No comfort required. Well,
I like these boulders. They're very moss-ridden, but I like them nonetheless. A little picnic there as well. Haven't been on a picnic in a while. Have you?
I have.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Oh.
What about you?
Was it good? Is that a baguette? I think there's a baguette on that.
Oh, there's two CTs here.
What is this?
The double spray down. Hello, stereo spray down. I don't know if you can call it a spray down, but I'm going to go with that because I can't think of anything else.
Why not?
So it's a stereo spray down.
It's developing into another sketchy round as was the previous one. Always caught the bomb. That's massive. 30 seconds to go. Peter's going to hit the shots. And this time he will miss. Pulls out the 5-7 and will pursue the bomb and the player, and he will claim the bomb. And there's no time not to go to B at this point. They cannot go to A. So the CTs know exactly where they're coming. They picked up the two AKs. Only one player with Kevlar. Peter's got to hit these shots. There's the first one. Sean gets down. But the AK now starting to do work. And the second one's been picked up. Peter, oh, great game sense there. Able to take down Ricks on the flank, but now he's running low on time. He's going to make the cross. And with the flash, he will have the cover to do so. There is the plant. And Peter needs now to figure out how to play this. He should have seen the drop into water there, and I think that he did. He's expecting the push-up slope. But will Ichiban peek from there? How will Ichiban handle this? There is the flashbang, Peter. Pushed off momentarily. And here it comes down to the clutch. And there you go, Peter. So consistent.
4K with an AWP on overpass. That's not easy in that situation where almost all his kills were close range.
Peter's
that's crazy. That is pretty nuts, because I was just thinking to myself, like, is it too much to ask to win a round where your opposition have absolutely no money? But Peter, I mean, that's like the most unlikely way to do it with an AWP from close range, 4K.
On both maps, he's been the difference maker as per usual. I mean, we see good performances from Legia, from Gubby. There you go. Nicely done, the wall bang. That does actually work out sometimes, especially if you get the Molotov in place and they're trying to push at the same time. So we can review my thoughts there towards the end here, because this could be the end of the line.
What line, then?
The finish line. The end of the finish line. I don't know if that makes sense. But it's just Sean Gers left. He's standing on the line, James. He's now off the line.
Could be the end of the line on a dynamite stick, for example. Doesn't really roll off the tongue very well.